We're on the way to Greenham Common's former baseball pitch. The seating area and scoreboard is original, dated around the 1980s.
Right,
so at Greenham Common now, folks. I'm going to check out the US baseball location for the Army base. This actually looks 100% American, doesn't it, this thing?
Yeah, it's very American.
That's crazy. So the US put that there.
Oh, that's a bit slippery.
Chris is going to stack it.
If anyone's going to stack it, it's going to be me because I've got slippery boots on.
Isn't it? It's showing it, the wood's showing its age.
Yeah. You'd think that would give it a bit of a scrub, wouldn't you?
Good view though.
Let's go up here then.
Careful.
That is really slippery.
You've got wellies on.
That's stupid slip. Yeah, I've got walking boots on, they're even worse.
So they used to watch the game from here, folks. Now it's a football pitch, but it was baseball. There is archive footage of them playing, isn't there, I think, as well.
I think there is, yeah. But I've just noticed something, though. If... I wonder if this has been repositioned.
Because it only faces half the field.
Well, yeah, not only that, but look at the scoreboard. You can't even see it.
Yeah, scoreboard's over here. We'll have a look at that in a minute. It's there.
So if you're sat here, you're not going to be able to see the scoreboard. So this might have been moved at some point.
Yeah, it's true.
Because what this essentially just looks like a metal frame with wooden planks on it, doesn't it? Scaffolding planks.
It's a bit at the... It's very one way, isn't it?
Yeah.
As well.
So it looks like it could have theoretically been just picked up by a crane and moved.
Yeah.
Which is what they probably did if it was in the way when they came to make this football field here.
Yeah. I don't know how big a baseball pitch is.
Neither do I.
Have a sit down and see what it looks like.
No. That's it. That's how it's done. It's quite cool.
Do you feel American now?
Certainly do, mate.
Well, to all the American fans that are watching this, which I hope there are plenty of, I hope you enjoy this.
Yeah.
It brings back some memories.
American made. Proper.
So I know a lot of ex-servicemen, women, they went back home after the base shut.
Yeah.
People watching this film may well have relations that were here.
Yeah.
Greenham Common, folks. Real history. Right. Let's go and look at that scoreboard then. Do you want me to set the camera?
Good.
Yeah, it's a simple design, isn't it?
Well, I'm just wondering if this was... I don't know the American counterpart, but like Royal Engineers maybe fabricated this?
Yeah.
So it looks pretty simple, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. Bit of welding, bit of bolting.
The year of it, I don't know. I highly doubt you're going to find a snap anywhere on anything on it.
There it is, scoreboard. It looks a bit different, it looks like it's been touched up.
I think it's been repainted over the years, yeah.
Yeah, but what do you notice about it? You know how good its condition it is and no one's wrecked it or put graffiti on it. Which is good start. Well, I'll say that. And these look relatively new. So the scoreboard will be original, but the RSJs look rather new to me. What do you think?
I'm not sure. The picture I see of it looks sort of older than it is. like you say, it could be done, retouched up with paint and that, but...
I mean, the top bit's knocked around and patched up enough for the original.
We'll have to have a look at some photos.
And can anyone that was based here back in the day, can anyone tell us if this scoreboard was electrical?
I was thinking.
So I can see what look like electrical vents in the back panel here.
Yeah.
So maybe there were lights behind it.
Yeah.
So that'd be interesting to know if it was actually electrical and it lit up.
Obviously gaps there.
They've riveted gaps.
This is exactly what I was thinking.
So behind those plates there would have been numbers or letters or whatever.
Yeah, but you'd either have to climb up there to change it.
So there would have been a platform here, look.
Yeah.
So on this bit, would have been bolted a platform there.
Yeah.
And then some steps leading up to it.
Yeah, but maybe at some point it's been changed later on. Because there's, like you said, there's air vents in the back and there's like inspection bits. I'd have said it was electric.
Yeah.
Or at some point in its life.
They might have been updated. They might have updated it.
You know what I mean? So you'd had like a bit of like an LED screen sort of thing.
Yeah.
With a number comes up.
LED was the first one that came up.
Yeah.
Do you know, that could be original, because the more I look at it, have you seen in the... possibly being sandblasted or something, because you can see where the rust is eating into bits, like down the front here.
I suppose.
Look there.
Yeah.
And the random holes.
And if anyone also knows.
And the rust. Look at the rust in there between these two, where it's forced, the rust has forced it apart. I wonder at some point if the signs have been down and they may be sandblasted and painted it well.
Possibly.
It took me maybe even tidy the sign up.
Yeah.
Because you can see all bits of it look like tape or something, don't they, with the letters.
Yeah. Amazing.
It's a lot bigger than it. You know, it's a lot bigger than it looks as well, actually.
Which isn't it?
So I'm just wondering if that was over here at some point.
Yeah, because baseball pitches ain't that big, are they? Not really.
But even if it was at an angle over here, so you'd see that and the sign all in the...
Yeah.
Would that have been all the seating, or would they have had more? Is that...
To be honest, I don't know.
Have they just saved,
how many people do you think you get on there? 15 people to a row? How many rows? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 rows there?
Yeah. Amazing. So, yes... That's the scoreboard. These buildings over here, folks, are marriage quarters. The Americans built. Greenham Close. Thames Valley Police. Oh, Rope Wars. Thames Valley.
Right, so where we're at now, so Mill Hall, formerly Greenham Lodge, I believe was the officer's mess.
Greenham Lodge was built for Lord of the Manor of Greenham, Lloyd Baxendale, by architect Richard Norman Shaw in 1881. It was sold in 1938 and then used in the Second World War as an officer's mess. On the 5th of June 1944, the night before D-Day, President Eisenhower's personal driver reportedly tried to drive a jeep full of intoxicated soldiers up the main stairs. To this day, the tire marks can still be seen on the main staircase. From 1948 to 1953, Greenham Lodge became a school for the first time and was called Carmel College. In 1954, the house became a club for the United States Air Force officers stationed at Greenham Common. It continued in this role throughout the Cold War period until the closure of the base in 1992.
That's quite an impressive building.
Yeah,
it is. And I believe now it's a
primary
school.
School.
I think it's a school for the hearing impaired.
Oh, right.
So it has to. It's
that's an amazing building. Look at the chimneys on it. Let's step over here.
It's really nice.
Looks a bit Tudor. I think we should have a look at that fence over there.
Just go look at that.
Yeah. The fence is possibly, there's a slight chance it could be World War II, wouldn't it? Or it's more
possibly
likely
World
to be...
World War II, but it's more, most definitely 100% Cold War.
Yeah. Oh, these little artifacts, folks, you've got to see these things. Got to see them.
Obviously,
to believe.
Greenham Common was a different place back in, when was it? 39, 40, 41 to 45?
Yeah.
Until the Americans took over. And then the whole... The whole area around here had just completely changed.
Yeah. So, yeah. Americans might have put that up.
But hang on a minute. Hang on a minute.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Hang on a minute. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? Because there's one entrance there, and this is all... This is like a compound. And it's completely flat.
Could be tennis courts or... small football field or soccer, as the Americans would call it.
Yeah.
It's something, wouldn't it?
That just looks a bit flat to be true, doesn't it?
Yeah. Definitely. Especially because like that, it drops away, doesn't it?
Yeah, it drops away. We've got the gate there. It goes into the back of to the back of there. I've not noticed this before.
But yeah, it's completely fenced off. Look.
Yeah.
So if anyone knows what this was.
Leave it in your comment section, folks.
There's a lot of them, if anybody knows.
Yes, there is.
So what's in here then? Got barbed wire and all sorts.
Golf course.
Golf course?
Yeah, there's a hole there.
There is a golf course. You've got Crookham Golf Course. I think it's called Crookham.
There's a golf flag there.
Right.
So it's a golf course.
People playing golf over there. Need one of the air horns.
That would be funny actually, wouldn't it? My feet are wet.
Are they wet? Oh, bless.
Oh, looks like a punch bowl, so I call them.
A lot of barbed wire around there.
Could this be school related? Or do you reckon it could still be Greenham related? And
I don't, it could be both, because remember that was officers' mess, wasn't it?
Oh yeah.
Well, shall we look?
So it could be something like tennis courts and that.
Yeah,
mess.
I mean, it
something
just looks very conveniently flat, doesn't it?
So yeah.
I and it looks the same, you probably get what, two tennis courts in here?
Yeah.
If I was being optimistic.
Yeah.
So, and with the building there, obviously now it's a school, but with the building there being the old officers' mess.
That's quite an impressive school though.
It is, yeah. Yeah, that's definitely a bit.
So look at the size of that.
It's pretty old. So I would say, I would put that out there. But it's an American style bin. And it's pretty old.
If anyone wrote D1826 on it, please let us know. Familiar to you? Off the
top of the fences.
Yeah, it's off the
off
the perimeter fences. It looks like the same stuff.
Yeah.
Could well have been recycled from somewhere, couldn't it?
Yeah. That looks very strikingly like the one from the perimeter fence. In that white circle.
Yeah.
However it's called, I don't know.
Yeah.
See what I mean?
Barbed wire rolls.
I love all that barbed wire and this big hole underneath you're trying to.
But then again, some of those look new. So I don't know.
I don't know, it looks stainless.
It's weird, isn't it? Like you said, you've got that big flat area, and then you've got the big old dip, and then you've got the golf course. Yeah. There's another sort of flattish area. I wonder what the idea behind the big dip is.
Oh, I've had something stored there.
Is that just where they've dragged up the soil from to level it out?
Possibly. And if you look in the grand scheme of things as well, if you actually look at these trees, they wouldn't have been there back in the day either.
No.
No.
So there would have been nothing here.
Cool.
Right. Changed. A lot has changed.
The water tower was built between 1985 and 1986 to supply the servicemen and women of the 501st Tactical Missile Wing. It holds 700 cubic meters of water and is known locally as the wine glass.
You know, you've got the force of all that water pressure pressing down just on that bit in the middle.
Yeah.
So that has got to be super, super, super strong. Just to hold the weight of the unit itself, let alone the water that's inside it.
Yeah. Can't see the door, Chris, see if it's open. Ain't it?
No.
So obviously if the door was open, folks, we'd take a little peek. Yeah, because it's open. That shows you a bit of the height of it. Pretty high. Original path to it.
Cable TV. They're going to put
some form of security going on there.
Thingy, on top.
Madness. Just found something. It wasn't here last time. It was here.
Cable TV. And it comes. You've got a pipe going through here, look. And then you pull that through. They'll attach the wire to the end of it and pull it through with the rope.
Yeah, so that's brand new.
Brand new.
That is new. So that's a couple of months old. New.
So that's going to be something to be attached to the top of that. What's in it? Be CATV.
Cable TV, isn't it?
All right.
That's as good as. It's also. I can't remember what it looked like last time. These are relatively new-looking lots. Because you can see around it when people have attacked it over the years.
Oh, someone's pulled the electric copper, folks.
It's climbed often, isn't it?
Is the door open?
Yeah, it's open. We'll just walk in. No, it's not. It's got nice shiny new locks on it. Probably the local youth have tried it.
Shame they haven't opened it up for us.
Yeah.
The conductor there, taken from here, just ripped it. Wow, yeah. So this would this have anything to do with the Greenham Common airfield?
Okay, it did. So this water tower, if we can't see it now because there's concrete trees right behind us, but all this area down here now, Pigeons Farm area, is where the Murray Quarters were.
Right.
So this would have fed the base and Murray Quarters down here. All these behind you are new, that's way after.
Is it still in use?
I believe it is.
Would this feed the new estate?
I believe it is. I believe it does feed this area, yes.
You know what I've just realised? Look up there. Some of the tracks, this lightning
rod,
to there.
Alright.
Look.
It's not flush, is it? Go.
That wouldn't be fun to do. That's because it's been pulled off.
But you can see, if you look, you can see where it was attached to the wall. Yeah. So where they've pulled it down, it's come away.
Yeah,
at that
but
point.
Like this bit, you can do the ladder, but going up there, that is going to be a fun job, is it? I wouldn't want to be up there.
It's like a UFO, isn't it, on top?
It must have some serious strength in this base to hold that up.
There's another rod. Lightning conductors.
I don't think we noticed this time. We got, there must have been some electrical
in
panel with lights on.
In the tank light.
Yeah, so, yeah. So that looks like there was an electrical panel with lights in there. Maybe. Because there's a conduit for it. Hang on. There's something else there. You can see the outline of it. So there was another one.
In a tote effing empty.
Maybe another one.
Right, ready?
That's his inner tank. Is there more than one tank then? Wouldn't it just say tank?
What, an outer tank does it say?
It says inner tank.
Well, inner tank's the top one, isn't it? The biggest one.
Yeah, it says inner tank low, inner tank high. So yeah. Obviously it's just a...
Why not just put tank? If there's only one tank. Just put it out there.
Chuck it out there, folks, see what you think.
If anyone has a water tower fetish, please let us know.
I'll tell you, actually, though, from here, that'd probably make quite a good picture.
It is. Get your phone out.
Ain't got it.
So have a go at Chris there, because he's never got any phones on him to take pictures.
I'll take a picture. It'll be on Instagram before this goes out.
Next week, a crash at RAF Greenham Common in 1958. That sparked controversy even to this day. Greenham Commons alleged nuclear disaster.